Hey folks, welcome to another exciting What The Spec video. This week we're going to look at all you need to be able to build an awesome After Effects workstation, the incredible app that acts like Photoshop for video and allows you to create awesome effects like fire and so much more. So let's roll the intro and get started. Okay, so I'm Craig Hume, captain at Utopia Computers, an awesome computer manufacturer based in Scotland. On this very channel, I share tips for all things tech, as well as sharing my knowledge that I've built up for building computers for over 20 years, as well as working beside some of the best team in the industry. This video is going to focus on how to get the very best performance out of After Effects. To do this, I'll be looking at four key areas: CPU, GPU, RAM, and storage. If you have questions about any other components, like case choice or power supply, hit me up in the comments and I'm going to do my very best to answer them there. Keep in mind that each part that I'm mentioning has earned its place in this video through actual testing, benchmarking, as well as real-world feedback from Utopia's customers. So sit back, and by the end of this video, you're gonna know how to build the ultimate After Effects workstation in 2020. Oh yeah. So let's start with the CPU. So what CPU is best for After Effects? The CPU is a very important part of any After Effects workstation. However, be aware that a more expensive CPU doesn't always equal better performance, as there is a limit to the number of cores that After Effects can effectively take advantage of. While older versions of After Effects, we're talking 2015 and older, worked really well with high core count CPU configurations, including dual Xeon systems, due to the removal of render multiple frames simultaneously feature, the current version of After Effects actually runs better on more affordable CPUs that have a lower core count but a higher operating frequency. Currently, the CPUs we most often recommend for After Effects are the AMD Ryzen 9 3900X, followed closely by its sibling, the Ryzen 7 3800X, and then moving over to Intel's i9-9900K, which is also a solid choice. There are the incredible AMD Threadripper CPUs that can give you a wee bit extra performance, but we find that it's best to save your money there, move your money into more RAM, faster storage, rather than blowing the budget on a high-end Threadripper for After Effects. Now, I mentioned CPU cores. Do more CPU cores make After Effects faster? Well, After Effects gets better at using multiple cores all the time, but 8 cores is still generally seen as the sweet spot. The exception to this is if you use the Cinema 4D renderer, which works better with more cores. If you are using this, then look out for AMD's Ryzen 9 3950X. So does After Effects work better with Intel or AMD CPUs? Well, like I said, if you're going top end for After Effects, then it works best with either Intel or AMD. But I think you can guess I am loving AMD's options just now. So yeah, either one's good, but my preference is AMD. Okay, so what about Intel Xeon CPUs for After Effects? Well, the assumption's often made because they're more expensive that they will be better at everything, but it really is dependent on the apps you're going to be using. Xeon chips are not a great option for After Effects. The extra features they bring to the table, like ECC memory support, large cache, and enterprise level reliability, just don't benefit After Effects performance at all, and they come at a large financial premium. Stick with Intel's Core series or AMD's Ryzen chips for the best performance in After Effects. You'll still see Xeon chips getting mentioned in various forums as a good choice, and this is down to the fact that historically, they used to be the only option if you wanted large amounts of RAM or you wanted a dual CPU system. I promise Xeon chips offer no benefit to After Effects in 2020. So what about those dual CPU systems? Are they any good for After Effects? Well, historically, as I say, this used to be a good option. After Effects had that feature render multiple frames simultaneously, which benefited for having lots and lots of cores. But now that Adobe's removed the feature, rendering support's all been moved over to GPUs. So in 2020, dual CPUs, nope. It just doesn't make financial sense. As I mentioned before, if you are using the C4D plugin, then the better value here would be Ryzen 9 3950X. It's a super high speed CPU that's all that's needed for the win in Adobe After Effects. And moving on to GPU. So what features in After Effects use GPU power? Well, After Effects share rendering technology with the likes of Premiere Pro. Everything from color balance, curves, VR effects, and blurs all use your GPU. A full list of these features are available from the Adobe site, and I'm going to drop a list to that in the description of this video. Now, top tip time, make sure you've got the Mercury GPU acceleration enabled in After Effects for best performance. To enable it, simply go to File, Project Settings, click on Video Rendering, and the Effects tab. Make sure Use option to Mercury GPU acceleration. Depending on your computer and GPU, you may see multiple such options. So what GPU is best for After Effects? Well, the good news is that After Effects is still more reliant on CPU power. This means you don't have to spend the world on a top-end graphics card to get the very best from this piece of software. If you take a recent test of the NVIDIA 2080 Ti and compare that to a GTX 1660 Ti, there's actually only about 6% difference. This makes the 1660 Ti the sweet spot for performance. It's actually my personal favorite go-to card for After Effects users in 2020. Keep in mind, other applications in your workflow might have different GPU requirements that might be higher than After Effects, so consider that before making your final choice. How much VRAM, video card memory, does After Effects need? 6 GB is the sweet spot here. While you can get away with 3 GB, I would suggest that 6 GB gives a headroom for 4K and above screens, as well as multi-monitor setups. Almost all new GPUs will have 6 GB of RAM, so you really should have no problems here. Heard Quadro is good. Can I use one of those cards for After Effects? It's a good question. Quadro cards are phenomenally powerful. They're super reliable for mission-critical projects, and this can mean that they are a worthy investment for some users. However, for most users, GeForce simply offer better value. Quadro cards can easily be 4 or 5 times the cost, and they won't offer any performance increases in After Effects. At Utopia, we've also found the GeForce cards from popular brands like PNY to be incredibly reliable. So is NVIDIA or AMD best for After Effects? Well, in recent tests, we found little difference between NVIDIA and AMD cards of similar specs. However, historically, I've always preferred NVIDIA. It simply comes down to the stability of their hardware and the reliability of their drivers. Generally speaking, NVIDIA is rock solid. In a recent announcement, Adobe also announced that it's going to let users have extra features if they've got NVIDIA cards. So for me, NVIDIA, with its stability, wide support, and studio drivers, it's the winner here, hands down. Now, should you opt for one of GeForce RTX cards in After Effects? Well, right now, the RT cores, which are used for ray tracing, and the Tensor cores, which are for AI operations that are found in RTX cards, have no real use in After Effects. This means the aforementioned 1660 Ti is still the best option. However, if you're planning to future-proof and you have budget, then Adobe could well release an update which can take advantage of the aforementioned cores and unlock some unlocked potential. And moving on to RAM. So how much RAM does After Effects need? After Effects can eat RAM for breakfast. The length, resolution, and complexity of your project will have an impact on how much you need. Extra storage can act as a buffer here, and I'm going to talk about that in a little bit. But in the meantime, after some quick maths and taking into account how many seconds playback you're working on, times that by the frames per second, the resolution of your image, and the color depth, and it's going to give you a very rough number on how much RAM you need. In short, lots. Even basic projects can take up to 32 gigabytes of RAM, with higher resolutions or higher frame rates hitting 64 gigabytes really easily. Keep in mind, the storage cache drive will help you out if you run out of RAM, but your performance is going to take a hit. Also, top tip for beginners, keep in mind that your After Effects project you'll be working on, try and keep them to 10 seconds or so. This is going to greatly reduce the amount of RAM you'll need and will increase performance in your workflow. And moving on to storage. So what type of storage drive should I have for Adobe After Effects? Well, okay, you basically get two options here. You can have a mechanical drive, or you can have some sort of solid state drive. Mechanical drives are awesome for long-term storage, and they offer vast amounts of space for very little money. SSDs and M.2 SSDs, on the other hand, they're more expensive, but they offer huge performance gains for the money. And then there's the faster M.2 NVMe drives in this segment, which are certainly worth considering, as they're gonna give you a system boost with improved application load times and boot times. In fact, I've done a whole video on these drives, which I'll link below. My recommendation minimum for After Effects is to have at least one good size SSD, but I'm going to show you my sweet spot for configuration for those that are looking to get the very best out of your workflow. Now, What storage configuration is the very best for Adobe After Effects? Well, for everyday use, a single drive will do you just fine. But if you want a pro level setup, then you're best to think about having up to three drives, maybe even four. Oh yes, the best performance means a little bit more than your average gaming setup. Your first drive is going to be for Windows, for After Effects itself and any other applications you use like Premiere. An SSD or M.2 NVMe, if your budget allows, is what you want here. It's just going to make things really smooth. Second, you want a working drive. That's going to be for all your photos and for After Effects files. It's going to be using, mechanical drives are okay in this section, but if your budget allows, SSD or NVMe will ensure a slick workflow. Then you're going to move on to looking for your ultimate setup, and it's the third drive. And I mentioned this earlier on, it's the cache disk or scratch disk. This drive's going to hold temporary files, and again, it should be an SSD or NVMe drive, not a mechanical drive here. And then finally, as I mentioned, you could go for a fourth drive for long-term storage. Something like Western Digital's Red Drive is the complete ideal here. Keep in mind, not all mechanical drives are cut from the same cloth. Some brands are way more reliable than others, and some models within brands are also designed for completely different purposes. In fact, watch this space for a full video on mechanical drives coming very, very soon. So to conclude, what would be my ideal After Effects build that offers the best value against performance? Well, let's summarize. Let's make it really easy. Let's go for the AMD Ryzen 9 3900X, NVIDIA GTX 1660 Ti, 6GB, 32 to 64GB of RAM, and then a bunch of storage drives, generally leaning towards NVMe storage if your budget allows, and something like a Western Digital Red Drive for long-term storage. Capacities will vary depending on your projects and your budget. So, if you are interested in buying an After Effects workstation from Utopia, then please check out our range of high-performance After Effects workstations in the link below. If you have any questions about After Effects, or anything tech related at all, please drop me a comment. If you haven't already, please hit subscribe. Please, please, please. And I will see you on the next video. Thank you, everyone.